Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I want to share with you all the polish haul for the month of January and February. Yes, I have been very neglectful in sharing my haul. And now I have 2 months worth of polishes to share with you. So as per usual, I am not gonna be swatching any of these polishes. I just don't have the time to swatch them right now, whether it's on the nail wheel or live. I just don't have the time. So I'm just gonna show you the bottles I hope you like in this video. And thank you so much for watching. Before I continue on, I wanna let you know what I'm wearing on my nails. This is Bee's Knees Lacquer, but this is a turtle. I'm sorry, this name is so funny to me, I don't know why. But this is a polish that I received for PR and I really fell in love with it. I think it's perfect for spring. It's a reflective polish, which in the sunlight looks like magic. And it has green and pink, which are two colors that I am obsessed with right now. They definitely feel like spring colors to me. Green and pink together, or green and purple. I just find that those two color combos look so pretty. I also want to let you know that I use What's Up nail plates in Bravo 017 or B017, sorry, I'm so used to phonetic alphabet. This image right here, which is the four leaf clover, are what I stamped on my nails. These are the two polishes that I stamped them with. This one here is Maniology in Ducky, is the first one I stamped with. And this one here in Beauty Big Bang in 003 is the second stamping image. I made kind of like a, you know, pond effect with the stamping. I really like the way it looks. I think it looks really pretty. Right, so I'm going to share with you in no particular order. If I remember when I got the polish, I will state when I got the polish, but for the most part, it's been so long that I don't remember if I got these in January or February and they kind of got all clumped together. I usually try to keep them separate, but because I've been piling them on together, they just kind of got mixed up. So we'll go from the first polish I'm gonna share with you all is this Colores de Caro in XOXO. This one I know I got in February. I definitely got this one in February when she restocked the first time for this polish. I knew that I had to get it. At first I wasn't gonna get it because the reflective glitter, as I'm saying this as I'm wearing a reflective glitter, but the reflective glitter trend is not that, like, it doesn't interest me that much. However, that being said, there are certain color combos that I have to get, or certain colors that I'm gonna have to get in reflective glitter. And this red one totally spoke to me when I saw it. It's just so beautiful and bright, and I think it'll look good as a Christmas polish as well as a Valentine's Day kind of polish. And I really had to get my hands on it, so I went and purchased it. I placed an order for KB Shimmer when she was having her sale, and I ordered this Oh My Gourd because it was on the, like, going out of sale, like leaving the website, and I've always wanted to get it. I've been eyeing it for a couple of years and I was just like, let's just get it now. I also purchased this KB Shimmer cuticle pusher because I have heard good things about it, and I love my gloss cuticle pusher, but sometimes I feel like I overdo it, and that's where I get like little dips and valleys on my nails. So I'm trying to use something that will be a little bit more uniform around my cuticle, and I feel like this does a really good job. It also has this end here where I can kind of like dig up some of those hard to pull out pieces from my cuticle bed. I placed an order for Cuticula because I've been eyeing these colors for quite some time. This first one here is Samantha from the All Is Found collection, which is the inspired by Frozen 2, which is on replay at my house a lot. My daughter loves Frozen. She also likes Frozen 2, but she prefers Frozen. And best of all, she likes Encanto, which is like a story for another day. But I really have been eyeing this one because it's so beautiful. Oops, I almost dropped it. I'm not a big fan of glitter crellies. I've mentioned this plenty of time before, but there are some color combinations, especially springtime color combinations, that are very hard for me to resist, and I've been eyeing this one for quite some time. I had purchased Bloom, I think, from the PPU whenever it came out from Cuticula during PPU month, and I've been wanting to get this one as well because I've been wanting to wear them for spring. So these two, that polish and this one, are going to be in my spring collection very soon. Yeah. Spring collection, I meant to say like spring rack. I don't know why I said collection. Then we have this Cuticula in its Pixie Crush. Now this one is smaller pieces of hollow flakes than her other, she has another one that's called I can't remember what it's called. Something else. It's called something else. But this is the smaller flakes that is for this. And this is a topper. And I just love the way that this looked on everybody that I've seen wear this. But when I got this, I tried it on a swatch wheel. Let me see if I can find it. And they're a lot bigger than I thought they were going to be. Even though this is supposed to be the smaller one, it just looks really big. They look really big. So I don't know how I feel about it. Or maybe I just don't like it over this color. So I may have to try out different different ones to see which one I like best. I think I may have purchased this in January, maybe in February. And this one here is Night Owl Lacquer. I'm dangerous in a sexy way. I purchased this during a de-stash, but I can't remember when I purchased this. But I purchased it in the de-stash, and so I finally have it. Super excited to get it. Sometimes I don't get things because I think, oh, I have something like it, but then I don't know, I just keep thinking about it, and that's when I have to hunt them down. And this was one of them. Another polish that I purchased in a de-stash is this Kikimora from the Witcher collection, and I really, really am glad that I got this because it's a UP, and I love me some UP, and I wanted this one, but I restrained myself, and then I had to get it. This ethereal lacquer came to me, I want to say in February, maybe in March, I don't remember, but I purchased it early on. This is Hecate from the Matterhorn and Ethereal Duo. I did not purchase the oil, just the mystery polish, and it is a beautiful polish, but again, I have so many polishes like this that I think I am done with mysteries for a while. It's hard for me to get mysteries that are not going to be coming back. I tend to get them because of the hype of the brand that I really enjoy, because of the theme that I really enjoy, and then it's something like this, which is beautiful. I'm not saying that this isn't beautiful, but again, I feel like I have copious amounts of purple shimmer polishes, you know? So do I need another one like this? No, not really. So while I really think that this is beautiful, so pretty, I'm a little disappointed that it's in a color I feel like I have so many of, and as much as I love purples, I'm getting to the point where I want more unique things, or if I'm going to purchase something, I want to be able to see it before I purchase it, is basically where I'm getting from. So the last two other collections from Ethereal that were mysteries, I just didn't even bother to look at. I did purchase something from her Persephone collection, but I only purchased one polish, and I did not purchase a mystery because I was just like, no, I'm not gonna do it. Another polish that I purchased, I want to say I purchased this in February. This is Nailed It, and this is a resold. What is it called? The ones they still have a lot of polishes, and this is Amok Amok Amok. And I remember looking at this and really liking the way it looked, but I don't know why I didn't get it. It doesn't say when. It just says HHG Hocus Pocus, but it doesn't say when it came out. Now this is a magnetic, and that's one of the reasons I got it, because I just love me some magnetic polishes, and I thought that this looked really, really pretty. All right, so these three I got from the Fandom Flaky for January of 2022. The first one we'll talk about is this Fair Maiden, and this is in Hometown Dates, and it looks like it's a reflective glitter, but I'm not sure if it is. I can't remember, and it looked so pretty and so full of sparkle that I had to get it. Oh my gosh, it is a glitter polish, so I think it's going to be hell on your nails to remove, but oh, it's so pretty. We have a Night Owl Lacquer from the same box, and this is the Final Rose. Oh, this is the Bachelor one. That's the Bachelor theme, Fandom Flaky. Again, this is a jelly, red jelly polish that looks so beautiful. Now, it does lean a little bit more pink red in real life. It's showing a lot more truer red on the viewfinder, but regardless, it's so pretty. I'm really in love with this kind of polish, so I'm glad that I have it. And then finally, we have Champagne Gate, which is a Bee's Knees lacquer, and it is that beautiful shimmer with hollow flakes in there that I absolutely love. So pretty. I don't know, there's something about these types of polishes that I automatically gravitate towards now. Bee's Knees lacquer totally suckered me in with this formula. I have the Sparkle and Shine box that I purchased for the month of, I don't remember what month this was. It may have been January as well. I want to say it was January. First, I have this beautiful Nailed It in Secret Menu. This was the Sparkle and Shine was the coffee. So this was the coffee house theme, which was like Starbucks drink. So this is the Secret Menu, because everybody knows that Starbucks has a Secret Menu. And this is a beautiful purple flaky balm from Nailed It. They do these kind of polishes so well, and I have so many of them. I don't know if I'm going to keep this one just because I feel like I have another Nailed It that looks very similar to this, although the flakies in here are different than that one, so I may try it out before I destash
it. Here is the Wildflower Lacquer one, and this is the strawberry cappuccino. So cute.
I think this was inspired by a fan artwork about the cappuccino, maybe, I don't know, but it's really a really pretty, almost coral pink. I really like it. It looks very
pretty.
For me, the star of the show was definitely this Bee's Knees Lacquer in Pistachio BSC. This one is just, this green is so beautiful. It's such a bright green, and I swear, like, my lights are covering up. There's hollow flakes in gold in here that, like, bigger than the shimmer of gold that's in the bottle, and it looks so magical. I really like the way that this looked. For me, this was definitely the star of the show. Another green polish brand that I purchased is this one in Little Olive. This was from the custom group, the Olive Polish Custom Group. I saw this, and at first I wasn't gonna get it, but the more I looked at it, the more I loved it, and I was like, yeah, I gotta get me some. Shannon from Polish does, these greens are, she does them so well. I absolutely love Polish green polishes.
Next, we have a Wildflower Lacquer. I do want to say about this in January. This is the Dr. Frankenfurter Polish Flicks Limited Edition Polish. Look how beautiful this is. Now, tell me that I wasn't on... There was definitely a green trend that I was on when I purchased these polishes. They're thankfully not as similar as I feared that they would be, but similar enough that I was like, did I really need to get this one, knowing that I had gotten this one? Yes, I did.
Another wildflower that I got that January was Tomorrow is a Brighter Day, and this one was a limited edition. This polish was a limited edition as well, and I just had to have my hands on it because it's such a beautiful polish. Yes, it's another hollow flaky, and again, another purple hollow. And like I was saying before, you know, when I know that it's what I'm getting, it's different. And actually, this is a lot more intense, like deeper, and has a lot more color shift than it's showing on the bottle. Like right here I see a pink, and then on this side I see more of it like an orange glow, but on the camera you're not seeing all of the amazing color that's on here. And again, not to say that this beautiful polish isn't beautiful, but whereas I knew I was getting this was a mystery, a surprise, and had I known what color it was, I probably wouldn't have gotten it. Does that make sense? I hope that makes
more
sense.
More polishes from the Witcher collection that I purchased myself.
Here is this name, because you can't have a Witcher collection without this. This is Geralt's favorite word. And this, as you can tell, is a reflective polish. It's so, so beautiful. I absolutely love it. Now, I did get the PR for Bee's Knees Lacquer. So I did get this polish from Bee's Knees Lacquer, which is the for PR, which is Viva Atlantic City. And it's basically these two colors, like, inverted, basically. This one is a red base with blue glitters. This one is a blue base with, or purpley blue base with red glitters. Did I say blue? I meant red base. Did I say that right? I don't know. Regardless, I got this one in PR, and I had to purchase this one because I fell in love with this one, and they're both fantastic. Oh my God, look how beautiful they are. I could wear these together, but anyways, we're talking about this one here. Again, I'm not big into the reflective glitter trend, but there are some that still call to me. We have this one from Bee's Knees Lacquer, which was a return. This is Lithi? I don't know. But this is a unicorn pigment polish that I missed out the first time it came around. This is Empire of the Vampire Collection. I remember when this came out the first time, I think Rachel from Polish with Ray talked about it, and I really loved it, and then I put the alert on my phone for an hour too late. Like, I was so sad because I knew that this one was going to sell out quick because it's UP and she didn't make that many, and I put the alert, but I didn't remember that it was... She put the alert for Eastern time and I put it for Central time. So by the time that I went on Bee's Knees Lacquer, it was sold out and I was really bummed out about it. But when it came back, I definitely, you know, purchased it. I had to purchase
it. This one is another from the Witcher collection, and this is She Is Your Destiny.
So beautiful. Oh my God, I just love blues like this. And then we have
the law of surprise from The Witcher as well, because oh my god, I had to have both of these blues. There was so many from The Witcher that I really wanted, but I narrowed it down to my favorite, and these two were it, obviously, and the this one here, and these three, and they're all blue. Do you see that? There was a theme going on in January. I think I bought these in January. So in January, I did purchase from Ethereal when she came out with her Witcher collection. And of course, you can't have a Witcher collection without this word, like I said. And this is a polish that even if it wasn't named this, I still would have fallen madly in love with it because it's so pretty. This is just ugly pretty to me, and I love it. Now, I did have to purchase the mystery for the Zodiac mystery. This is the last one, I believe, Sagittarius, for December of 2021. I purchased it in December, and it came in January. So now we go into Never Naked by Jackie, which I placed an order in January, I want to say. So these are from her December winter collection, I think holiday collection. This is Just Be Claws, and it's a beautiful red with like almost bar glitters. Oh my god, they're so pretty. Like, so dainty. I love them. I'm excited to wear this. I love this color red. Of course, I had to get Oh Christmas Tree. This is a topper, if I'm not mistaken. If I remember correctly, I remember seeing her top this off on other polishes. Really love the way that this looked. I am such a sucker for Christmas polishes or Christmas toppers, and this one just screamed to me. And then we have Blue Christmas, because yeah, I was definitely in a blue mood. Sitting there for a while, I was definitely in a blue mood in January because I purchased a lot of blues. And finally, guys, I purchased, let me see if I can zoom out. I purchased 6 polishes from Cirque Colors early January, late December maybe, if I remember correctly. So, and they're all magnetics. Yay. All right, so we're gonna start with this first one here, and this one is Mood Ring. And this looks like a blue to green magnetic. If I look, yep, looks like it's blue. The base is blue and the green is magnetic. Very, very pretty. So pretty. Oh, it looks like a face. Here we have is Mobius. And yeah, I just could not resist these polishes. So it looks like it's a teal green base with this lighter blue shift. So pretty. Oh, it looks like it has a purple shift to it. Like, looking at it in real life, I can see some purple shifts and I cannot capture them on camera, which is very frustrating. Now we have a purple one. This one is called Dream Within a Dream. Oh yeah, so this looks like it's a bluish base with purple shimmer, blue, purple to gold, almost pink. Oh my god, I'm so excited to try these. Next we have Paradox. Oh my god, this looks so amazing. So this one here is like a almost like oxblood kind of jelly, and it has that blue purple. It looks more purple to me, but on camera it's shifting a lot more blue. But in my line of sight, which is pointing this way, I can see some purple, a lot more purple. Here we have Kinetic, and this one I wasn't that like crazy about, but I felt like at that point I needed to just get them all. This is another one like a oxblood like red with the red and golden magnetic shimmer there. Oh my god, this looks so pretty. Then finally we have Eye of the Beholder. And this one, oh my goodness, let's see. This one here is like a dark brown base, and it has this like whiskey color kind of shimmer. Oh my god, so beautiful. Look at that. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited to wear these. So that is it. Those are all the polishes that I have purchased for the month of January and February. I'm looking around to see if I have anything from March that maybe I can, oh yes, I forgot. Place an order with ILNP in the month of March. I'm just gonna add these in here because why not? I mean, I just wanna clear out the area that I have. I actually did really good in February purchase-wise, March as well, sort of. I mean, today is the 11th of March when I'm filming this, and I haven't purchased that many. I did purchase these though, so I'm gonna share these with you because they came in. This first already. One here is ILNP's Tinsel, which is basically the sister topper to Empress. Yes, this is the silver version of Empress. I just love ILNP's small, dainty flakies. I don't know, there's something about how small they are, how well they spread on your nails that I really, really love. And I was like, why not? I mean, honestly, this is still my favorite of the year, which is the Hollow Flakies from Fair Maiden and Ice. This is still my favorite, but there's something about how small and dainty these are that I really want to try with different colors, different color combinations. This is ILNP's in Confetti, and I did purchase this in replacement of that Rogue Lacquer that I had. I had a Rogue Lacquer called, oh my God, I can't remember what it's called, but I know I shared it in one of my haul videos, but if I remember, I'll make sure to have it on the screen. But this one, that Rogue Lacquer was basically full coverage. Even though on the site it said that it was a topper, it was basically full coverage. I did not enjoy the way that it looked because it wasn't what I wanted. So I decided, since I enjoyed Empress so much, to purchase Confetti, which is basically what Empress is, but with rainbow flakes in there. I also have another rainbow topper. This one here from Painted Polish, this is called Top of the Rainbow. And the only thing I don't like about this one, it comes in a darker base, whereas this one comes in a clear base. And I think I like that better because I have, I just don't like the way that this darkens up my polish a little bit, my base
and
polish.
Then ILNP was discontinuing some of their polishes. I didn't want any of their full polishes, but I was interested in this topper, and this is called Fully Loaded.
Well, apparently I ran out of space on my card and I don't know where this left off. So this is ILNP's Fully Loaded, and it is a topper. It was on sale. I don't know if it's still on the site, but this is like a blue to green to violet flaky topper. I have an old polish that is very similar to this, but the formula on it, not the greatest. So I decided to purchase this one. It was on sale because they were trying to discontinue it. That's the word I was looking for earlier. They were trying to discontinue it, and so I decided to purchase it since it was on sale and it won't be around for long. And yeah, that led me to the other two polishes that I have been eyeing as well.
All right, now we're really truly done with this video. Thank you all for sticking around for this long video. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments down below, what did you end up purchasing for the months of January, February, and or March? Because apparently I added some March polish I ended up sharing some March polishes as well.
So don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.